you join me in our call to worship, knowing the fate that awaited him.
Jesus rode into the city on Sunday, and he shouted, "Hosanna!"
Knowing that we would betray him.
Jesus broke bread with his disciples on Thursday, and we let him watch our truth.
Knowing why the soldiers look for him tonight.
Well, let me see his suffering and our sin.
Jesus will answer, "I am he," and we will not defend him.
Let us worship in the shadow of the cross.
Behold, the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world.
Thank you.
Would you join me in this prayer responsively? We stand near the cross, O God, disturbed, distraught, discouraged. Yet we gather here as disciples, those whom Jesus loves. In the face of such suffering, show us the face of our Savior. In the shadow of such evil, show us the light of your grace. On this day of great solemnity, let us stand as witnesses to your great love for the world, revealed in the outstretched arms of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Then Judas Iscariot, who was one of the 12, went to the chief priests in order to betray him to them. When they heard it, they were greatly pleased and promised to give him money, so he began to look for an opportunity to betray him. On the first day of unleavened bread, when the Passover lamb is sacrificed, his disciples said to him, "Where do you want us to go and make the preparations for you to eat the Passover?" So he sent two of his disciples, saying to them, "Go into the city, and a man carrying a jar of water will meet you. Follow him." When it was evening, he came with the 12, and when they had taken their places and were eating, Jesus said, "Truly I tell you, one of you will betray me, one who is eating with me." They began to be distressed and say to him, one after another, "Surely not I." He said to them, "It is one of the 12, one who is dipping bread into the bowl with me." Would you join me in the first verse of our Holy Jesus?
Let us be going.
see my betrayer is at hand. Immediately while he was still speaking, Judas, one of the 12, arrived, and with him there was a crowd with swords and clubs from the chief priests, the scribes, and the elders. Now the betrayer had given them a sign, saying, "The one I will kiss is the man. Arrest him and lead him away under guard." So when he came, he went up to him and at once said, "Rabbi," and kissed him. Then they laid hands on him and arrested him. But one of those who stood near drew his sword and struck the slave of the high priest, cutting off his ear. Then Jesus said to them, "Have you come out with swords and clubs to arrest me as though I were a bandit? Day after day I was with you in the temple teaching, and you did not arrest me. But let the scriptures be fulfilled." All of them deserted and fled. Let us sing verses 1 and 2 of "Go to Dark Gethsemane."
Clearly enough
to break our hearts. He will be there to ask us each again, do you love me? As soon as it was morning, the chief priests held a consultation with the elders and scribes and the whole council. They bound Jesus and led him away and handed him over to Pilate. Pilate asked him, "Are you the King of the Jews?" He answered him, saying, "You say so." Then the chief priests accused him of many things. Pilate asked him again, "Have you no answer? See how many charges they bring against you?" But Jesus made no further reply, so that Pilate was amazed. Now at the festival, he used to release a prisoner for them, anyone whom they asked. Now a man called Barabbas was imprisoned with the rebels who had committed murder during the insurrection. So the crowd came and began to ask Pilate to do for them according to his custom. Then he answered them, "Do you want me to release for you the King of the Jews?" For he realized that it was out of jealousy that the chief priests had handed him over. But the chief priests stirred up the crowd to have him release Barabbas for them instead. Pilate spoke to them again, "Then what do you wish me to do with the man you call King of the Jews?" They shouted back, "Crucify him." Pilate asked them, "Why? What evil has he done?" But they shouted all the more, "Crucify him." So Pilate, wishing to satisfy the crowd, released Barabbas for them. And after flogging Jesus, he handed him over to be crucified.
Thank you.
They compelled a passerby who was coming in from the country to carry his cross. It was Simon of Cyrene, the father of Alexander and Rufus. Then they brought Jesus to the place called Golgotha, which means the place of a skull. And they offered him wine mixed with myrrh, but he did not take it. And they crucified him and divided his clothes among them, casting lots to decide what each should take. It was 9 o'clock in the morning when they crucified him. The inscription of the charge against him read, "The King of the Jews." And with him, they crucified two bandits, one on his right and one on his left.
Thank you.
When it was noon, darkness came over the whole land until 3 in the afternoon. At 3 o'clock, Jesus cried out with a loud voice, "Eloi, Eloi, lama sabachthani," which means, my God, why have you forsaken me?" When some of the bystanders heard it, they said, "Listen, he is calling for Elisha." And someone ran, filled a sponge with sour wine, put it on a stick, and gave it to him to drink, saying, "Wait, let us see whether Elisha will come to take him down." Then Jesus gave a loud cry and breathed his last. And the curtain of the temple was torn in two from top to bottom. Now, when the centurion who stood facing him saw that in this way he breathed his last, he said, "Truly, this man was God's son." Let us sing verses 1 and 2 of Word.
Until finally the footsteps are heard
and the noise of the voice of God is upon us. The Holy One is not afraid to walk on unholy ground. The holy work is done, and the world awaits the dawn of light. Our Christ candle remained lit, reminding us that death does not have the final word, and that God is with us in all times and in all circumstances. Would you join me as we sing our final hymn, When I Survey the Wondrous Cross, verse 4. God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, so that everyone who believes in him may not perish, but have everlasting life. Indeed, God did not send his Son into the world to condemn the world, but in order that the world might be saved through him. May Jesus Christ, who for our sakes became obedient even unto death, even death on a cross, keep you and strengthen you.
Amen.
Go.